morning.
Hey, my name is Mike.
How are you?
Good.
I got it.
Yeah, so you had to wait here.
He's gonna come get me. What do we got here behind the magical curtain right here? Well, look, Bob, it's a U.S. boiler Burnham ES2. Yay!
Oh,
is
that? Okay, because we are getting heat.
All right. No circulation. I remember, this is the one where the contractor, the bathroom. Remember the bathroom?
Yeah.
I remember that. You had no circulation on the first floor. All right, everything looks pretty clean. I did notice this. It's dry, though. Good. All right, we'll give a little tune-up here. We'll fire up, we'll flush out the zones, make sure that there's circulation there, and get the show on the road. All right, we're gonna turn on the zone one floor first. I did tell the homeowner, ground floor, first floor. I bet you this one comes on. What do you want to bet? Here it comes. One, two, two and a half. Come on, one, two. Two and three quarters. Two and five eighths. I swear, sometimes if you want the job done, you got to do it yourself. All right. Let's turn on our combustion analyzer before we fire anything up here. Good. Come on. One, two. Give up. Let's dust off the equipment. There it goes. Bingo. Dirty in there. Come on, baby. Beautiful. All right. Now they're all in. Okie dokie. Not that cooperative, are you? Beautiful. Let's see what's the bomb in this water heater. Yay, cocky. Just a little bit of crap on the bottom. Now she's clear. prints on the front cover. Good stuff. Get in there, Biddy. Get in there, buddy. Come on. There you go. Beautiful. All right, so looking at a thermal scan of temperature on a picture. So you can see our, in the center of the screen, that's our supply pipe going across to the air separator. Below that is the expansion tank. Between the expansion tank and the air separator, right in the dead center, is our pressure reducing valve. And right before that is the upstream of it, is the backflow prevention device. We just had zone 2 come on the second floor, and you can see it slowly heat up before your eyes. So now zones 1 and 2 are on, and that pipe going upstairs is heating up. If we take a look at the return piping, it's also heating up as well. There's the basement, or the ground floor. And then there's our upstairs chimney in the flue piping. So they give us this corrugated, yes, it's on. They give us this corrugated flue piping to gain efficiency, and 225 degrees, no, actually 137, and here it is 175. Big difference. And there's our water heater, and then there's that piping leaving the boiler, going to our ground floor. Here's a piece of baseboard. Pretty cool. All right, take a picture of the combustion results and attach that to the customer service ticket. Beautiful. Not that one. Excellent. All right, let's do a quick component identification. This is the probe for the low water cutoff IQ module on the inside of the boiler. 30 PSI relief valve, drip leg, triticator gauge, Xtrol number 15, Hydronic thermal expansion tank, half inch pressure reducing valve, half inch double check valve, air separator, inch and a quarter IPS, Webstone circulator isolation flange without purge, Taco 007E ECM high efficiency circulator, Webstone circulator isolation flange with purge on both ground floor and upstairs, automatic vent damper, SR502 Taco 2-zone switching relay, 2-zone, inch and a quarter by, that's 1 inch, manifold with 1 by 3/4 reducing 90 on both. Here we used 1 1/4 by 3/4. Under the hood, Hydronic boiler control, IQ option card for low water cutoff, the IQ option board, intermittent pilot ignition gas valve, a little more dust in there, and six stainless steel burners. Right there, that white thing, the two black wires, that's the rollout switch. And right here is our resettable block vent switch or spill switch. Boiler feed valve. Ironically, coincidental, it turned off the boiler as soon as I did that, but let's take a peek. Right now, STA 10 is retry recycle delay. Interesting. STA 7 is flame proving. STA 8 is running. Let's see why it did that. Boiler temperature 150. We are running. Set point is 180. High limit 180. TT is on, of course. Domestic hot water is off. And flame 0.72, 1.16, 1.1, 1.51, 0.63, 1.08. Something's not right with that. 0.8, 1.1, 1.31, 1.30, 0.41. All right, let's see if the boiler's at temperature. No, so it's churning off before 1.51. We have low flame current. It looks pretty clean. All right, so after cleaning that pilot burner yet again, we're at 15.6, 15.5, 15.9, so we're much better. Much, much better now. Yeah, if it goes below one, it's going to kick itself off with error 10, retry, recycle delay. And if it does that a couple times in a row and it's not sensing that flame or flame current, it'll do a hard lockout. Now, the manual doesn't tell you what those numbers need to be, at least I didn't find it, but over one is generally the rule of thumb. On a new pilot assembly, you'll be in the double digits. If you just clean it good, you'll be in the single digits, but 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, north of six is preferred, but we good.
Now, I already know what you're all thinking. Mikey Pipes, if you would have took out that main pilot burner, on that main burner, and cleaned it, when you had all the other burners out, you wouldn't have been doing what you did now. Correct! Correct. It's all good. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.